Is Tan France still hiding his marriage from his family? How is Jonathan Van Ness being woke about battling an incurable disease? Which two experts cannot stand each other in real life? Let's roll the clip to unveil some grim behind-the-scenes info about the iconic Queer Eye cast. Jonathan Van Ness revealed his HIV diagnosis. In the 4 years we've watched the Queer Eye series, we know one thing for a fact. Jonathan Van Ness is a ray of sunshine in the team. A grooming expert who makes everyone around him feel their best. His bubbly personality, positive energy, and sense of confidence are to die for. Basic? Never heard of her. That's why the news came like a lightning bolt last year when Jonathan opened up about being diagnosed with HIV at 25. In his memoir, Over the Top, the 33-year-old star shared how he had been battling his illness for years and felt like he had a responsibility to speak up and end the stigma surrounding HIV-positive people. JVN had to come a long way to move past his traumas. Death threats at elementary school, an eating disorder later on, and sexual abuse all led to a downward spiral of self-destructive behavior and drug addiction. Van Ness said that the moment he heard his diagnosis, it marked a new beginning for him and the end of his addiction. The release of his book wasn't easy for the star. The Queer Eye expert had to prepare mentally for months to show his vulnerable side to millions. On The Late Show with Stephen Colbert, Jonathan revealed, "I think that a lot of times people think that if you've been through hard times, that you can't be seen as positive or gregarious or happy anymore. I just wanted to share that, honey, she is an onion with all sorts of layers." And that's why Van Ness should be proclaimed a spiritual guru of the 21st century. He doesn't just transform your hair, he transforms your soul. Tan France nearly turned down Queer Eye? When you look at the immaculately dressed Queen of Shade, Tan France, you think, does he ever doubt himself? The Fab Five fashionista doesn't just do style transformations. France is the one to imbue self-confidence in the show's heroes. But prior to the show, the star had little to no confidence himself. When auditioning for the QE, Tan recalled, "I don't think I even wanted it. I didn't know if I wanted to be in show business. I was just so nervous. I was the guy who wouldn't even take photos. There were no real photos of me online." And look at him now, slaying the Instagram game with his fashion style. And how can we not mention his gorgeous silver hair? The transformation didn't happen overnight, though. Tan experienced racism and severe bullying growing up in the UK, which had a massive impact on the star. The fashion advisor revealed that he even tried to bleach his skin when he was younger to fit in. It made him question whether he could handle the pressure of representing his Pakistani culture on TV. Luckily, France made a whole 180-degree turn and completed the team in this revolutionary makeover series. "I could have an opportunity to change the narrative for my people, so I decided to take the actual audition to show that Pakistanis are wonderful people, that we are caring people." Tan was born to help give a sense of confidence to others, yet he became one to earn it as well. Are the Fab Five not friends in real life? 4 years of Queer Eye has taught me true friendship, unconditional love, and genuine support. But the Queer Eye experts are not as funky and friendly in real life as they seem on screen. Who would have thought that Anthony Porowski and Karamo Brown didn't hit it off as besties from the very beginning? The two kept it sweet and professional on screen, but could not stand each other off set. In an interview with E! News, Karamo revealed, "People don't know that we had an extreme amount of conflict. We did not talk to each other at all during season one, even though we were shooting together." Up to this day, the two have not spilled any details as to what the reason behind the conflict was.
I just explained the reason!
But apparently, a mysterious third party was to blame. Brown explained, "Our personalities got along, and once that third party got involved, he and I couldn't even talk to each other. We were too busy hearing rumors of what this third party was spreading about both of us." Wow! Who would dare to badmouth Anthony, heartthrob of the year, Porowski, and Karamo, please marry me, Brown? That's when Karamo put his psychotherapy diploma in action. The two Queer Eye experts sat down and talked for a whole hour to settle their conflict. As you can tell, months of rivalry were over just like that. Queer Eye member passing. In 4 years of the Queer Eye, our favorite team member became adorable Burly. Burly was a 10-year-old French bulldog who stole the show and our hearts along with it. He was Michelle Silva's dog, one of the producers on the show, and an essential addition to the Fab Five experts. Burley was a star and fetched 267,000 followers on his Instagram account. Bobby Burke, the interior design expert on the QE, dedicated a post on his Insta to his friend captioned, "Rest in peace, my furry little friend. You brought joy to so many with your jump kisses, grunts, and even your farts. You were the best little sidekick we could have had. You will be very missed by all." It wasn't made public, but Burley had suffered from a heart disease for a while. His passing was unexpected for the audience and a heartbreaking loss for everyone involved. The Queer Eye will never be the same without you, Burley. Tan France hides his marriage? Yep, you heard that right. France grew up in a Muslim household, went to the mosque on the daily, and had no contact with anyone outside his community. He knew he was gay from an early age. He just didn't know what it was called. Here's the thing. The word gay was never mentioned in the household Tan shared. His father did not live long enough to witness Tan's coming out. He passed away when France was 13. But if he had known the truth, he would have completely disowned him, the QE star shared. The fashionista revealed that his mother was the only one to accept him, unlike the rest of his family, who are yet to meet his husband Rob France, who he's been married to for 13 years. The family didn't attend their wedding, and only began acknowledging his husband's name after the show aired. Even these days, Tan has to hide his ring when he travels to certain countries, which breaks his heart that such a thing is necessary for his safety. The world we live in. Anthony Porofsky had it coming out via text? This show represents the queer community and shatters people's ideas about gay people, raises awareness about the issues of race in the US today, and toxic masculinity. It is way more than just a makeover show. When watching the QE, we see the Fab Five as role models who come in and help their heroes out of their mental rut and get their lives back on track. But in reality, the Fab Five struggled themselves. Let's take Anthony Porofsky, who never had an official coming out at all. The star revealed that one day, when his father was dropping him off at the airport, he commented on his son's discreet lifestyle, and Anthony thought it would be an appropriate time to drop a coming out bomb on him. Via email. Porofsky recalls typing, "You brought this up. I think it's time I tell you. I love you. I am loved. His name is Joey and we live together." That was it. Wow, so casual. Karamo's wisdom came from a dark place. "Let me count how many times Queer Eye has made me cry. I don't have that many fingers." To explain that, you'd have to look into the personal journey of each Queer Eye member, how the experiences they went through made them able to relate to others and grow. In 2003, Brown took part in The Fifth Wheel, a heterosexual reality dating show where he hid his true sexuality. In his autobiography, Karamo revealed his severe drug addiction back in college, succumbing to a very dark place and attempting to terminate his own life. I almost cannot equate this story to the open and unapologetic Brown we know him as today. In his book, Karamo revealed, "There was no point in existing, but I was given a second chance to accept and support and to ask for help. And today, I am living my dreams and am surrounded by love." In 2004, The Culture Expert became the first openly gay black man on TV. In the years to come, Brown worked under the Obama administration, creating support for the LGBT+ youth, and launched his own nonprofit. Brown said, "If you get help, your life can change. I'm living proof of that." He never stopped giving back to the community and is always there for the Queer Eye nominees to get the support they need, even when the show is over. Anthony Porofsky tried to revoke his Polish heritage? Who would have thought that prior to Queer Eye, the master chef of the series, Anthony, was not only closeted about his sexuality, but was also determined to change his last name for a more American one? Anthony confessed that growing up with Polish immigrant parents in French-speaking Montreal made it very difficult for him to adjust to the US school when they moved to West Virginia. He spoke Polish, French, and English, yet his linguistic skills were not really appreciated by his American peers. In fact, he was bullied big time. And his ethnically diverse lunches and his surname didn't help. Although Porofsky still considers Polish to be his first language, he was considering changing his last name to something more American, like Porter or Portman to fit in. Thank God he didn't act on it and left it as it is. Anthony revealed that his last name helped him connect with his Polish fans, who began reaching out to him on social media and sharing their experiences. So, if there is anything you can take away from this video today, it's that you have to stay unapologetically yourself. Never feel ashamed of your background, your past, or the way you identify yourself. Being yourself is the way to succeed, and the Fab Five is living proof of that. Comment below which fact you were most surprised by. Hit the like button and subscribe for more content like this.